In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who stretches out the heavens, who sends light to the nations, who gives breath to us all. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Loving God, we confess that we have turned from your way to follow our own ways. Forgive us for the times we have spoken or acted too quickly. We have not spoken or acted at all. We have hurt those closest to us. We have hurt those we have yet to know. We have thought more about ourselves than others. We have thought less of ourselves than we ought. Turn us around and give us a fresh start so that we can live again as your children. Amen. Even when we have done wrong, God makes us right. Even when we have messed up, God puts us together. God's love never runs out. God never tires of calling us beloved children. Hear God say to you now, your sins are forgiven for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Glory to God in the highest and peace to his people on earth. Lord be with you. Let us pray. Holy God, you confound the world's wisdom in giving your kingdom to the lowly and the pure in heart. Give us such a hunger and thirst for justice and perseverance in striving for peace, that in our words and deeds the world may see your life, the life of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Who may abide upon your holy hill?
Those who fear the
not cast his credit upon a neighbor. They do not give their money in hope of gain, nor do they take bribes against the innocent. Those who do these things shall never be overcome. The second lesson this morning comes from 1 Corinthians, the first chapter. The message about the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and the discernment of the discerning I will thwart. Where is the one who is wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the debater of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of the world? For since in the wisdom of God, the world did not know God through wisdom, God decided through the foolishness of our proclamation to save those who believe. For Jews demand signs and Greeks desire wisdom. But we proclaim Christ just crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles. But to those who are of the call, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. Consider your own call, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in the world, things that are not, to reduce to nothing, things that are, so that no one might boast in the presence of God. He is the source of your life in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God and righteousness and sanctification and redemption. In order that, as it is written, let the one who boasts, boast in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Work. We're going to make it work. We're raising volunteers first. Thank you, Betty. I appreciate that. They rejoice and be glad. Yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are they who show mercy, mercy shall be theirs. Blessed are they, the pure of heart, they shall see God. Rejoice and be glad. Blessed are you, holy are you, rejoice and be glad. Yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are they who seek peace, they are the children of God. Blessed are they who suffer in faith, the glory of God is theirs. Rejoice and be glad. Blessed are you, holy are you, rejoice and be glad. Blessed are the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who suffer hate, all because of me. Rejoice, be glad, yours is the kingdom, shine for all to see. Rejoice and be glad. Blessed are you, holy are you, rejoice and be glad. Yours is the kingdom of God.
Thank you very much. Grace, mercy, and peace go to you from God our Father, and our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Sven came running over inside the store where Oli was, and they said, Oli, someone just stole your pickup truck from the parking lot. And Oli said, did you see who it was then? And Sven said, no, but I wrote down the license plate number. I want to talk to you a little bit about wisdom. Wisdom and intelligence. Understanding. There's wisdom and then there's wisdom. I told a story once in a while when I was in college and taking an education class. They were talking about wisdom and knowledge in this class, and I raised my hand and I said, did intelligent people create the atomic bomb? And the teacher looked at me and said, I would have to say yes. Then I said, then I have no idea what intelligence is. Doesn't sound very intelligent to me, does it? Create something that could destroy the world. Depends upon your understanding of intelligence, I guess. Your understanding of wisdom. There are lots of great lines and lessons for today. Paul has in 1 Corinthians, I will will destroy the wisdom of the wise. The discerning I will thwart. That is God talking. He's going to destroy what we consider to be the wisdom of the world. Verse 27 and 28. But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in the world, things that are not, to reduce to nothing things that are, so that no one may boast in the presence of God. Not a single person on the face of this earth has something to boast about. Nothing. The only thing we have to boast about is to point to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, that he's here. That's the wisdom we need to seek. There's an author and a philosopher and historian, mathematician by the name of Bertrand Russell. And he said some pretty cool stuff. This is one quote of his. He said, the whole problem with the world is that fools and fanatics are always so certain of themselves. If we stop and think about that, they are. But he goes on to say, wise people are always full of doubts. Think about that. The people who know exactly what they're doing, exactly what should be done, exactly the way things are always the most foolish. The ones who say, man, I'm not too sure. I'm not too sure about this. What should we do? What's the best way to go? I have all these questions. They are the most wise. We end our Bible study class on Thursdays, and inevitably there is someone who comes up to me or says at the end that they have more questions than they had when they went in. And I always try to tell them, that's good. That's good. I don't worry about anyone who has questions. I worry about the people who don't. The people who are so absolute with their wisdom. It's almost always wisdom of the world that they're absolute about. That Jesus attacks. That the Bible attacks. There's a parent who asked his kid what he learned in school that day. The kid said, I learned that 3 times 2 is 6. The parent said, well, that's not correct. The kid said, well, then I guess I didn't learn anything. So what'd you learn today? What'd you learn yesterday? What'd you learn about the grace of God? What'd you learn about the love of Christ? What did you learn how to be shown? When I was a little boy, we lived in this house that was a ranch-style house, a small house, but it only had one bathroom for 10 of us, and 8 kids and my parents, and it was a very small bathroom. So you couldn't take your time in the bathroom and get in and get out. I kind of learned that at an early age. Something that really helped me was that when I was a kid and I would sit on the commode and we looked directly across was the bathtub. And just above where I would be seen, right in my vision, directly ahead, was this one tile that looked like a witch. And the witch had this hand that was coming out like this. This hand. I pictured that tile like it was history. That scared me to death. So I learned to never take too much time on the toilet. I was in and out. Scary, that thing was. I think it's scary to think what God was, isn't it? We sometimes just want to hear what he has to say and then go out, leave right away. Because it's scary what he's asking for. It's absolutely petrifying. Throw out your wisdom, he says. The wisdom of the world. Look to his wisdom. And his wisdom has to do with things like love one another, forgive one another. Blessed are those who have all these needs. God wants us and our egos to become less, so that the truth of his love becomes more. That's the wisdom he wants. It becomes not about us, but about him, to redirect things to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. When I was with Peaches, my record store, I got passes to everything in Toledo. I mean, everything. I actually got passes to the zoo, the Toledo Symphony, any concert I wanted to go to in Toledo, Cleveland, Cincinnati, Columbus. Got passes to museums, all sorts of things in Toledo, because I managed the store. That's why. Because they wanted some favors from us, and we would give them favors, you know. You scratch my back, I'll scratch yours, one of those kind of things. Free copies of any recording I wanted. We had these meetings in Detroit where most of the record labels had regional offices there. They'd open up these closet doors, and these things were huge. They'd open them up, and they'd say, take whatever you want, for free, because I managed the store. When I left Peaches, guess what freebies I got? Absolutely nothing. Because those same people felt I couldn't really do anything for them. So why should I get anything for free? And that's what I really needed. Anybody know about Jack Jouet? Jack Jouet, sounds better. How about Tench Tillman? How about Israel Bissell? How about Paul Revere? Those other three guys rode that same night that Paul Revere rode. Paul Revere traveled about 20 miles. He's finally caught by the British after only going 20 miles. Israel Bissell, for example, rode 125 miles. He actually used up two horses. And after going to Lexington and Concord, he went to New York and Philadelphia, Israel Bissell did. Now, Paul Revere did a little bit of riding, but like I said, he only went 20 miles. So why in the world do we know Paul Revere and we don't know Israel Bissell? Anybody want to take a guess at it? Paul Revere had better PR. Pure and simple. Better PR. There's this guy named Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. And he wrote the poem of Paul Revere's Ride. Became famous just like that. Instantly famous. If you stop and think about it, if he would write the same poem about the midnight ride of Israel Bissell, you know, doesn't have the same ring, does it? Paul Revere, midnight ride of Paul Revere, listen to my children, and you shall hear. PR. The world has all this incredible PR. And when you listen to it, we go after it. There are people who believe that the church needs just good PR. If only we would have good PR, then everything would be fine in the world. That's our problem. We just don't have enough good PR, like the world does. And I don't think that's our problem at all. I think our problem is that we need to live our faith more. We need to trust our faith more. We need to have one-on-one, reaching out to one another more. The fact is we are the Bibles most people read. We are. They're watching us. So do we point to our wisdom? Do we point to the wisdom of the world? Do we point to the wisdom of Jesus? The wisdom of God? We're always pointing to someone's wisdom. And which one are we? Oli was talking to Sven, and Sven said, Oli, look at that dog over there with just one eye. So Oli said, where? I guarantee you it's not the same thing when you look through the wisdom of Jesus. He sees people totally differently. He sees this world totally differently. It's not the same thing. Okay, imagine this. Imagine that you're on your way to your car after a service, and suddenly this huge dragon comes up and roars and spits out fire. There you are, nowhere to turn, nowhere to run. Can't go back inside, can't get inside your car. What are you going to do? You know what you should do? Imagine something else. That's right. So imagine a world where the wisdom is always Jesus. Imagine a world that is Jesus and Jesus alone. That would be an incredible blessing. A blessing for us all. Amen.
Let us make confession of our faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty.
Please join me in prayer. Called to be a light to the nations, let us pray for God's justice, peace, and healing. We pray for wholeness in the body of Christ. Bind up fractures within the church. Humble the proud and lift up the lowly. Make us one at your table. Hear us, O God. We praise you for the beauty of the universe, for the light of the stars, for the majesty of the mountains. We thank you. Mold us into stewards of your creation. Hear us, O God. We pray for peacemakers around the world. End violence, restore communities, stop bribery within political systems, reign with justice and peace, and commit us to this act of discipleship. Hear us, O God. We praise you for this congregation. Bless the work and play of young and old. Deepen our faith, expand our discipleship, equip us to do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with you. Hear us, O God. We praise you for all the saints who died proclaiming the gospel. Strengthen us through their witness. Hear us, O God.
We pray for our neighbors who mourn, who have no living water, who hunger. Provide their daily bread. Heal the forgotten, the lost, and our enemies, family and friends. We include in our prayers this morning the family of Spencer Johnson, Linda Lincoln Kurtz, Elaine Abel, Wyatt Clawson, Dave Cobb. We pray for the family of Barb Cooper, for Jackie, Dave and Betty Meyer, George and Cindy Pope, and Bob Messer-Betty, Marcus Mountcastle, Tom and Eleanor Morgan, Susan Allen, Ruth Kerrigan, and Josh Bainwright. For Russ Van Meter, Tom Badenhoff, Carol Barrowin, Steve Baker, and Krista Bem. For Connie Belts, Lisa Dublin, Don Bischoff, and Linda. Joe Borsman Clausing, Sandy Bossman, and Nora Brandt. For Jeff Brown, Denona Norris, Brandon Shane, Roman Brown, Carl Weekers, Irene Cordes, and Mary Lou Bowers. We pray for Norm Bossman, for Margaret Castello, Jeannie Curtis, Terry Doda, Marjorie Downs, Susan Dravis, and Crystal Garcia, Kelly Garst, Frank Gabers, and Mackenzie Dotsey, Allie Gray Small, Chris Hansen, and Theo Hoyer. For Linda Hill, Dustin Brown, Becky Hilvers, Jerry Holder, Richard Hoover, Alexa Jennings, Beth Jenny, Kathy Jordan, Allie, Lucas King, Carly Knowles, and Lynn Colby. We pray for Alice Langevin, Connie Lawless, Brent Leiter, and Sarah Lenhock, Mary Louise Weevil, Amber Lucas, Ken Newman, and Karen Lynch. For Kate Michaelis, Billy Miller, for Denise Edsberg, family of David Mix, Matthew, Todd Miller, Emma Myers, Landon Zunk, Shirley Myers Faces, Kevin Myers, John, Joe Mosher, Betty Mallory, Robin Norton, for Alice Silverhouse, Lois Potts, Rita Priggy, Naomi Rhodes, Kimberly Richie Small, Lucas Rosebook, and Simon Sapruno. For Valerie, Deb Shane, Chris Schmidmeyer, Arthur Schrader, Irene Smith, KT, Jet Thomas, Randy Volke, and Mary Brown. For Jeff Warner, Joe Weddington, Jackie Westhoven, Cliff Williams, Andrew Williams, Bill Winsman, and all those we name now in our hearts. Hear us, O God. We pray, Heavenly Father, for those in our congregational family who will be celebrating their birthdays in this coming week. Those people include Matthew Dilley, Thomas Schwab, Krista Amstutz, Daniel Ruby, Lake Biederstedt, Chandler Burpin, Carson Dotsey, Lenny Sonnenberg, Roy Valdez, Ben Flogus, and Trevor Cruz. We also pray for those serving in the military in this our congregation and this our country, including Mike Nemeshay, Matt Nemeshay, Tyler Hayes, Jessica Reed, Henry Helling, Hunter Cunningham.